All right, guys, we're back working on this 4G cylinder head today. If you've been following along with the videos for this, cool. If not, I'll give you a quick update. We've got this as a core. We hot tinked it. We've repaired some exhaust stuff problems it had, surfaced the flange, replaced valve guides, sized the valve guides. We've done our valve job, and we've converted it to a half inch stud. The next step for this thing in this video today, we're going to do some port work, and we're going to convert it to a larger head stud washer. I'm going to dive right into the port work right now and get moving on it, and we'll talk more about the head stud washer stuff when I'm finished with that. All right, so I've already done a video on the basics of porting, so I'll put a link to that at the end of this, but I'll give you just an overview of what I'm doing, what my process is. So the first thing I'm going to do after the valve job is done is I'm going to focus on shaping the short side radius from the chamber side how I want. And then when I'm done with that, when I'm happy with how that's turned out on all these different holes, dealing with the core shift and that kind of stuff, the short side is the most crucial part of the port. Right, so the short side and the valve job combined together. So after I'm done with this, I'm gonna roll the cylinder head over, and then I'm gonna reshape the short side radius changes into the runners on each side, right? So I think I did the exhaust side first in this video, and then I'll roll it over into the intake side after I get all that stuff shaped. After that, we're gonna roll the thing on its back, and we're gonna shape the combustion chambers. I've got a valve, basically some stock valves that I've cut the margin down on, so they have no like top at all to take up as little space as possible. I'm gonna put those in the chambers, and then I'm gonna shape all the chambers how I want. And that's basically the last step of the porting. And then we move on to just cleaning the head off real quick and cutting the head for the 1-inch OD washers. All right, what's up, guys? I got the cylinder head ported. I got it cleaned up, rinsed off anyway. I got it stuck in the bridge port. I've already leveled it to the cutting head of the bridge port. We're ready to cut it for those 995 OD washers. I'm cutting it to a 1-inch hole, the washer pad there. The reason that's important is the standard washers that come with like a standard ARP bolt burrow their way into the washer pad. We put a larger OD washer in there to prevent that. When that happens, when that washer, the factory or the ARP washer will burrow its way in that washer pad, it results in a loss of torque on that stud, which can eventually lead to a head gasket failure. The additional surface area of the larger OD washer helps that washer pad withstand the additional clamping force from an L19 12mm, like this would normally be a 12mm head stud, or this one is getting a half inch 8740 stud, and that will just help that column from collapsing, help that washer stay on top of the washer pad, and the cylinder head stud torque remain what we set it to initially. So I'm gonna dive into that and get that done, so check it out. All right, so what I'm doing here, I'm putting the same drill bit I used to drill it out to a half inch to center the tooling, to center the machine on the cylinder head washer recess, right, or on the bolt hole. And then I changed the cutter to the 1-inch OD end mill there, and then we plunge that thing in there basically just until the surface cleans all the way up. A lot of times these are deformed from the old washers eating into the pad like we talked about. But that's what I'm doing, using the drill bit to center it on the hole and then the end mill to cut the washer pad. We're going to weld this dash 16 fitting into the front of the cylinder head. There's normally a soft plug there. I'm going to remove that, weld this fitting in place. The reason I do this later in the game rather than when I weld the deck surface initially is just fear of damaging this surface on this fitting. Then you got to cut it off, replace it. It's a huge pain. So I do it pretty late in the process here. So we're going to get that done. Then we're going to stick this thing on the decking machine. We're going to get it decked today. We're going to cut the O-ring grooves in it. That's actually the final machining process. After that, it gets finished clean. And then we start working on the assembly with the, this is getting a Ferreira valve and a Kigley race-only spring set. So we'll set stem heights, do the assembly process. I'm not sure how far we're getting into that today, but I'm gonna get the soft plug out, get this fitting in there, and get moving on it. As you can see, when you get the freeze plug out, there's a big step behind there, so I shaped that. The water exit of the cylinder head just to try to promote water flow. I don't want the fitting or anything in the cylinder head that I can avoid to restrict any water flow at all. That needs to be controlled by the pump. And that's also why we use a dash 16 fitting. I put a dash 20 in there, but the dash 20 just doesn't fit around the timing components. And I feel like a dash 12 is too small. Now, it might not create any issues. I know a handful of guys that do the dash 12, but I prefer the dash 16 for sure. It's just the biggest thing that fits in there. And then the pump is controlling water flow as much as it can. Obviously, there's still restrictions that we can't avoid, but we do what we can to avoid them. So get this thing on there and move on. All right, guys, we got the port work done, and it's cut for the 995 OD washers. If you want to check out more of this style of work, I've got a basic support work video here. I've also got a couple videos. Here's the first one of this cylinder head, watching it go from the core when we got it to where we're at now. There's a lot more to come with this, so keep an eye out for future videos with this cylinder head.